Hi guys, Stephen Palmer here, Michael Campbell Golf Academy. We're in the gym again, and I want to talk to you about injury prevention and warming up. So, what is the best thing we can do to prevent injury, or to reduce the risk of getting injured playing golf? Okay, the best thing you can do, without a shadow of a doubt, is always make sure that you do not swing beyond your current range of motion. So if you have, for example, 30 degrees of internal rotation around your rear hip, and you have only maybe 30, 40 degrees of rotation in your around your spine, that adds up to a 70 degree turn. If you have any more, if we take it to about 70 degrees, which feels like about there, if this is going to be your full range of motion, if that is the case in your hip and your torso. So if you're swinging beyond that, which most people do, if you start swinging beyond this range of motion, you're going to start making compensations, such as you may be hyperextending your spine, you may just be over rotating around those joints, they get inflamed, they get injured. So the best thing you can do is basically, sure, you've heard the cliche, people say swing within yourself. Certainly a time and a place to push those boundaries when you are trying to improve, but you've got to do it in the right way. But if you want to really reduce your risk of injury, you have to swing within your own range of motion. So that's a little bit about injury prevention. I want to talk a little bit about warming up as well. Now, golfers are notoriously bad at warming up. It's usually straight out of the car, shoes on, first tee. They might hit a few balls if they're lucky enough to have a driving range at their golf club, and it's not more than a 2 minute walk from the first tee. But if you don't have that luxury, and I'm really talking to the golfers here who are probably not going to do a warm up. So this is just a really simple way of warming up the major joints in the body, which are used for the golf swing, which are the hips, the shoulders, and the spine. So one thing you don't want to do, I have to say this, this is really important, don't static stretch before you play golf. So static stretching is, for example, if I were to go down, touch my toes, and hold that position. That is not an ideal thing to do. It might be, you might have this stretch, for example, just holding it. What this does, it has the effect of temporarily weakening the muscle's output, and it also changes the way the muscle reacts. So if you do a lot of static stretching before you go out, your golf swing is going to feel really different by the time you get to the ball on the first tee. So do not static stretch. You want to do some dynamic stretching to warm up the body's temperature, start lubricating the joints with synovial fluid. And some great examples of this, I'm going to give you three exercises that you can do. One is a simple shoulder circle. I'm going to stand with my hand on my shoulder just for a little bit of support, and I'm just going to make some circles with my shoulders. Now if you've got an injury, or maybe a slight lack of range of motion, you want to start small with this, and then maybe as you feel more comfortable, as the joint becomes a little bit more mobile, you want to make those circles bigger. You don't have to go fast, but you want to increase in speed as the joint warms up. You can go the other way too. Obviously, you want to do this on both arms. So shoulder circles are great. Hip swings, leg swings are really good as well. I'm going to stand this way to do this. I'm going to use a club for some support. And I'm just going to swing my leg. I'm going to keep it fairly straight. I'm just going to swing it back and forwards like this. This is going to help me start to lubricate my hip joints. And again, as you get more flexible, and as you get more loose and more warmed up, you can gradually make the leg swing even wider. And I'm sure you've seen everybody doing this on the first tee, maybe with a club on the back, or maybe just with it across the chest. Just some rotation side to side, making sure that you're not standing up, moving around, trying to stay fairly central, just to get your spine mobilizing. Now, obviously there are more effective workouts, more effective warm-ups that you can do for this, but like I said, the majority of golfers are not going to start properly warming up before they play. So this is something that you can all do. It takes less than 2 minutes, it's again, it's not completely optimal, but it's way better than nothing. It's going to really help you reduce your injury rate, and it's going to help you come out of the blocks when you go out on the golf course and hopefully not take those first three holes to warm up like normal. Going forward into the series, we're going to talk about some actual golf-specific workouts that you guys can do to increase your golf-specific fitness. So stay tuned for these. I'll see you in the next video.